Hello everyone, welcome to today's reading. We're going to find out how this person views you right now. How does he see you? How does he see you right now? Okay, so pile one, you will be choosing this this is the something or other pile one. It's escaping my mind, but I used to know what that was. This is the black obsidian, pile two. And pile three is the selenite wand. A little miniature selenite wand. This is the... Shit. I don't remember. Anyway, let's find out. Maybe they see you as a little, a little ditzy like me, yeah? That's cute. Let's see. Pile one. How does this person view you, first of all? This is how they see you. Oh, the swan. Very graceful. Delicate. Not wanting to offend people, which is really beautiful. They don't find many people like you. They think you are so geared towards the light. They love that you work for the light. How do they see you? Wow. Guys, I don't think you could have got a more beautiful card, to be honest. They see you like the swan. They see you holding back tears, fighting back tears, like you're overwhelmed with something. Yeah, I'm feeling like I want to cry, but I can't. It's like the black eyes here, right? It's like you're holding a lot of grief in your eyes. They see you sad. They think you're sad. But trying to take on happiness, like trying to be happy for everybody, but really inside you feel sad. They cry over you sometimes. Sometimes I feel like they think you guys are two peas in a pod. Like, they know you so well. They almost wonder why they know you so well. Like a mirrored image almost. Like, how do I know you this well, inside and out? I hear you're getting a lot accomplished. They see you running around doing a lot of things. I'm seeing somebody at work, so you might work with this person. They stop by your work or they work with you. They really do see you as burdened. Hopeless even, but hopeless in your own personal life, but yet trying to be the hope for everyone else. You might ascribe to the word starseed. You might think that you're a starseed. They see that in you as well. They see that you're very different in that way. Wow, there's something so graceful and delicate about you. Very feminine. I'm seeing the swan as a reflection. This person also thinks that a lot of people flirt with you. A lot of people reflect onto you what they want in a partner. They see that a lot of people project their image of what they think you are onto you. And that's not really who you are. This person swears up and down that he knows who you are inside and out. But other people aren't. They're really getting it wrong because they're projecting onto you. I just saw 420 on the clock. Somebody that smokes has been doing this lately. I heard you stuck your neck out for this person. Heard the name Randy. Hearing Clark as well. This is something your person knows about. That like people. almost villainize you. It's like they project, they think that you're so pure and innocent, right? And then they get close to you and they see that it's true, but it's like they can't conceptualize it. So they villainize you. They attack you. They make you feel like you're ugly. Like I'm hearing the ugly duckling. Like you're not wanted. Like you're not needed. This person, he, because the today is how he views, he thinks you're your soulmates. He thinks that when you accuse him of people pleasing, you're really actually looking at yourself because you people please a lot. That's what he's saying. You people please, and you don't know how to stop. You're so graceful and so loving, you don't know how to stop. He thinks you're so empathic that you pick up other people's darkness like a sponge. And I heard quack, like a lot of quacks come up to you, like really deceptive people who are fakes. They know they're fake and he knows they're fake. And you might even know they're fake, but you just still want to help them because, well, that's just who you are. You two are mirroring this problem though of people pleasing. Okay. That needs to be worked on. You need better boundaries right now. That's what he's saying. But I really think there's a mirroring element to this. So technically speaking, he needs better boundaries as well. So that's what he sees in you. Let's find out more about, well, I don't know. Let's just see what this card is. Muse of inspiration. Yeah. I'm just going to further this up. Could be a fire sign, a Leo, Sag, or an Aries. He sees that you are everybody's muse. Everybody's muse because you're so pure and so beautiful that you are the face that launches out 1,000 ships, I just heard. And I'm also getting the star card. You could be an Aquarius, but you're somehow in the public eye or something. People, everybody looks up to you, but then they look down to you. Wow, that's what I heard. Everybody looks up to you until they look down on you. It's like these two are angels, see the wings here, but then look how they're looking down. It's almost like everybody looks up to you until they start talking down to you and looking down on you. Sad. I feel like he cries a lot about you. Yeah. And that you try to inspire everybody. Again, you have a lack of boundaries, he thinks. He thinks eventually you're going to get worn out. Again, there's something with like twins here that you could think that you're soulmate or twin flame because it's, you know, I don't know how I noted, didn't notice with the twins here. Double. There's only two cards and they're both a mirrored image. Yeah. This is like a twin flame maybe. Wow. You both be fire signs or water sign, fire sign or both water signs, something like that. They could ride a motorcycle. You know, it's weird. I'm getting like the way that she's wearing black right here, right? But then it's something about your purity and your grace, but then it's like you wear all black or you wear dark clothes or you wear something that's just like it shows and proves that you don't care about society standards. Like you might not wear, you know, Versace or whatever the fuck it is, you know? You don't wear that. You're very real. How does he see you? Like an angel that's been misunderstood. Like a star seed. There are stars here. He actually sees you as like a savior of sorts. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That you're a star seed. But you're not getting the recognition that you deserve is what I'm hearing. You're everybody's muse. Who's your muse, pile one? He's like, inquiring minds want to know, who's your muse? Can I be your muse? Ooh, let's get a card on that. That's cute. Archangel Michael. This person's name could be Mike or Michael. First chakra. He's an angel too. I'm telling you, this person thinks that you two are like destined. There's so much sadness here. Oh my God, he cries. This man cries. Let's see if I can get a message about this. Number 35 can be important here. I can't believe you want me, fell on the floor. Are we past life soulmates? I told you, there's something very profound here. And then we have, what do you need from me? He wants to be your muse. You're his. He wants to be yours too. I'm kind of getting that the root chakra here with the first chakra is the root, right? I feel like there's something about you don't feel stable in your own environment or in your own space or your own job or even your own body. And he's kind of wanting to give you like a safe space. I love when you open up to me. Yeah. And you're a great kisser as well. Came out cute. He really wants to know how. He already knows how to help you. That's not a question. It's not how. It's will you let me? This is the kind of guy that would take charge, like take the lead. He's definitely an alpha. He knows what you want. He knows what you need. I don't even think you need to tell this person. I think that you guys are very telepathic. I think that this might actually be the real deal. Like this might be your twin flame for real. Heard something about coaching me. Let me see. Seven of Wands. You're coaching this person on how to draw boundaries and vice versa. Right now in the partnership, right now in the connection, you guys are learning about boundaries and how to defend yourself energetically. We have the Seven and the Nine of Wands. So a lot of energy warfare is happening because you two are like, well, telepathic. You're talking to each other. You're close to union, I think. Not for all of you, but a lot of you, well, are pretty damn close if you're having this much telepathy with them. They're learning about energy dominance and energy warfare. Okay. Psychic warfare. How does he view you? Oh, well, I just realized I have toothpaste on my shirt, which really sucks. I was recording and I didn't even know. Better than my face. Last time I had toothpaste on my face. So. Really cute. Kind of like, yeah, ditzy, like clumsy. Cute though. How does he see you? Cute. Different. So different. You're very unique. There's something about the way that you conduct yourself. It's like you will never stoop to the level of someone else. You'll never fight with anybody. Like that's how they see you. They kind of, you know, and I think this is the problem here and why the root chakra, he's coming through as the root for you, the root chakra, because he's kind of wanting to ground you a little bit, like pull you back into the 3D a little bit, because he's telling you that he thinks sometimes you use escapism instead of addressing the sadness. He would love to hold space for you, I'm hearing. He would want you to hold, to open up about. Oh, look at that. Hostilities. He wants you to get a little bit aggressive because with anybody, it would be with him. Not just with anybody, but with him. Because, well, he knows, one, you're safe to do that and, like, express, like, fuck you. I'm mad. I'm angry. You're afraid to express anger and sadness. And he's saying, you're safe to be that with me. I promise I won't judge you, and I promise I won't, like, get mean back. I'll just listen. Like, I mean, not to a point where you're abusive, but, I mean, there's something about, like, you just need to be like, you know what, fuck you, I don't like you. I don't like how you talk to me. I don't like how you do this. I don't like how you do that. Like, I feel something here, like, is brewing between you two, and it's gonna be this big, huge fight because he seems to think you keep hiding the shadow side of you, and you're just, like, putting out the light and only the light. But he really does like it when you open up. I mean, it says you have to let me in on the back. You have to let me in. I love when you open up, you have to let me in. That's what I have for you guys. If you want a personal, all the information's in the description. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. Hey guys, welcome to your reading. Those who chose the black obsidian. Hello. Well, I heard pipsqueak. I heard welcome pipsqueak. I don't know if this person has a name like that for you. Cute. How does he view you? How does he see you? I heard kind of messy. I just made a huge mess. I'm hearing you're kind of messy too. I'm getting star card in my mind's eye in this one too. You could be an Aquarius or have like an Aquarius North Node or something. He sees you kind of willing to start drama. Willing to just say anything you want because people are listening and people are listening. Like, people are really taking your advice right now. He sees you as willing to... Wow. Yeah. I'm hearing really go for the jugular. Yeah, that's what I'm hearing. Black obsidian. And I think it's because you really know how to protect your energy. And you know when you... It's almost like he's saying when it gets bad... Like, when pile two has to start yelling at people, like, you know it's been bad for a minute. He kind of sees you as messy. So you might, like, kind of live messy. Like, you don't clean up the place or something, yeah. Your hair might be messy. I heard your life is messy. How does he view you? Sea serpent. Ooh, I'm getting evil eye here, yeah? He sees you as very spiritually protected, but you also talk a lot about, like, energy warfare and people not being fair to you and fair to others. He sees you as a champion for change. He sees you as someone that came here to break chains for people. Both in your family, and I'm also hearing worldwide, so you could definitely be in the spotlight, pile two. How does he see you? As a leader, yeah. You could be a Pisces. I'm seeing a dragon in my mind's eye. That could be important. A dragon tattoo, maybe, or the year of the dragon. I'm not sure what I'm getting here. How does he see you? Hypnotic. Like a dream, like a fantasy. I heard like a wet dream. This man has wet dreams about you. He's fantasized about marrying you, proposing to you. I heard the name Scott. I'm also hearing Andrew or Andrews. Mesmerized. I can't stop staring. This person stares at you on social media. I feel like when they look at you or they look at your eyes, it puts them in a trance-like state. They feel extremely high around you. 3:33 on the clock, that could mean something to you. This person has dreams about you. Fantasy dreams. Wet dreams, yeah. You could be a water sign. They think there's more to you than meets the eye. They want to know. They want to know more, but they know a lot of people want to know more. It's not just you. It's not just them, I mean. They know a lot of people want to know more about you. So I'm hearing them say, I'm a drop in the bucket. They probably don't even want me. how does he view you? Like, insanely powerful. Like spiritually speaking, I think he thinks he's already pretty powerful, and you take it up like 10 notches. Two of Pentacles. You know what I'm getting? It's like you protect people. You have this very balanced nature, and that you can protect people who aren't yet acknowledging their shadow side. So they're kind of vulnerable to the dark energies of the world because they don't yet know their demons. So they get involved with really toxic things and people and attachments and stuff. And he is telling me that he thinks you're here to free people. This is more than a crush. This isn't even love. This is worship. Again, I'm getting water sign. Like, a water sign is, you're either a water sign or they are. This is not love. This is like infatuation. It's beyond stalking too. It's like glorification. This is glorifying. This man is glorifying you. Veneration. Worship. This is worship. You are so different in that you can mix so many different styles. You're very eclectic. You can piece together different things and make it work for you. It's just your natural expression. They're also telling me that a lot of people have tried to copy you in the past and they know they failed. And not only did they fail, they got bad karma for doing that. You had a lot of copycats in the past. People have just stopped trying to do that, I'm hearing, because they can't replicate it. They can't copy you. Something about a choker necklace. You might wear a choker necklace. Something about roses. I should have bought you flowers. Held your hand. If this is an ex, they're still not over you. They're telling me they'll never get over you. They love you. You know, I don't think you guys want to be with this person anymore. I mean, maybe some of you, this is the person you're with now. But for the ex that I'm channeling, I'm actually getting there's no bad blood here. They think that you are the one that will forever get away. Like, you're the one that got away. How does he view you? Appreciation. You can't make it up, guys. There's a flower in her hand. I should have bought you flowers and held your hand. That was so... Guys, I'm so sorry. My whole body just jolted. What? That was so loud. I heard I dropped the ball. Oh my God. I think it was a dog dropped the ball upstairs. I heard I dropped the ball and I didn't buy you flowers. I didn't tell you that I appreciated you. I know what I did wrong. I should have brought you flowers. Could be a Capricorn you're dealing with. Hold your hand. This person worships you. They will forever be like your biggest fan, even if they're not, Guys, I am so sorry if that scared you. That scared me too, so. But I'm just so sorry. Like, that probably jolted you. That basically gave me mini PTSD. Oh my God. Let's get a message from them. Hold your hand. Should've give you all my hours. If this person had a redo, they would do it over totally different this time. I don't know that you want them to do it over again, but stress out. Wow, how weird is that? I got so freaked out. Look, I want to protect you. Look, you protect people. That's how they see you. You even might be stressed out at how much work it is to protect other people. Other star seeds, I heard. I feel like when this person was in your energy, you often needed to take time out we need to take time out. We need time to sort this out. I feel like you needed to take time off and out of this connection because you needed to clear your energy and protect yourself. Again, because something about, they were shallow is what I'm hearing. They were very shallow. I'm hearing mushrooms that could be important to somebody. They were shallow and they, you had more depth in them and they're recognizing that now. You were always the deep one. I heard, which is ironic, either because they're older or because maybe their zodiac sign is a deeper zodiac sign, or I don't know. They're telling me it's ironic that you're deeper than they are. So what, I don't take it as it resonates, guys. There's your reading. I love you. If you want a personal with me, all the information's in the description. I'll talk to you later, guys. Bye-bye. Hey, guys. Pile three. Those who chose the Selenate Wand, welcome to your reading today. I just saw Mickey Mouse, and I'm seeing an amusement park. You could have been to an amusement park with this person. I heard Chuck E. Cheese, some sort of fun kid arena or kid event, kid something. I don't, a child something, like a playground. Let's see. How does this person view you? I'm hearing nostalgic. Something about you could have known this person when you were a kid, or like years and years and years ago. Sharp, very sharp, very smart. Like bachelor degree smart or master's degree smart. A lot of degrees smart. you could also be into astrology is what I'm hearing. They think that's so cool. They think it's really cool that you're into this stuff. How do they see you? They think you're a good time. That you're the life of the party. I'm getting an Aquarius. I see Aquarius. I hear like Brittany or Bethany. I'm seeing somebody go to a bar. A woman. I'm seeing a woman dance on a table. I'm not saying you have, but that's how they see you. They see like the life of the party, like you would do something like that. Oh, so fun, yeah. I'm hearing, you're kind or extinct, like the bee. You're kind or people. This person is smitten, honey. Ooh, Ace of Pentacles, yes. How do they see you? Like an artist. Like you use fun in art. I don't know how that resonates, but when you do your art, whatever it is, your projects, your fun, you're eclectic, you're off the wall, you're even kind of different. Like you do something that's different and it's like, I don't know how it works, but it works. And it's like nobody else could try it. Nobody else could do it. And also they see that you start a lot of new projects all the time. Like if you're ever bored, you just start a new project or a new book or a new something. It's like, you're just like, oh, I'm done with that. Something new. They see you as never bored and never boring, that you're the life of the party. You could have met at a wedding. I'm seeing a wedding in my mind's eye right now. I mean, this could be your spouse, I suppose. How does he see you? Like a flower. You blossomed right in front of this person. They once saw you like really struggling and you built your way to the top. Blood, sweat, and tears on your own. I heard your own advice, on your own advice. I don't know what that means. Maybe you like giving advice, but you said, I don't need to give people advice. I need to take my own advice. They heard you take your own advice. I heard the name Ryan. Anthony. Something you do might be a little taboo. Like unorthodox, yeah. Like not mainstream. They think it's really cool. At first they didn't though. At first they were kind of like that. I don't like that. I don't know if it's like OnlyFans or maybe you're a dancer or, oh my God, I just accidentally threw this card down and this one came up. This one was on top. It said up all night. If you're a dancer, you're like a night dancer, a nightclub dancer or something. They didn't like that at first. I am hearing them say they wished that you wouldn't have to do that. And guys, I don't know. I mean, everybody's allowed to do whatever they want. It's your body. Do what you want, right? But he is saying that it's a point of contention in the friendship or the relationship. Like what you have to do to make money for someone here, your person is like, I wish you didn't have to do that. Not in a judgmental way, just in like a really caring way. But yeah, you built yourself up, I'm hearing. You put yourself through nursing school for somebody. You put yourself through school. You're an enigma. How does he view you? He sees you as an enigma, always willing to do new things, very independent and very fun. Life of the party. Extremely independent. You know, it's like a bee. There is a beehive, yes, technically a bee colony, right? But the bee all day acquires pollen, right? Or does whatever it does. I don't know what a bee does. All by itself. It rarely comes into contact with another bee during the day, you know what I mean? But there is a colony. So, I mean, it belongs somewhere, but they see you very independent a majority of the time. How does he see you? I keep seeing like a model, or you do something to pay your way through school. You do something that's like, it's different. It's not like a normal 9-to-5. It's like photography or dancing or ballet or art. You do tarot maybe. I don't, it's something different you do that's not normal, like mainstream. He sees you as an incredibly hard worker. And he knows that that is a real gig. Like whatever you do, it takes work, it takes time, and it's a pride of yours. And this man is very proud of you. I heard for some, this could be your own dad. Or granddad. Adjacent possibilities, yeah. When one door closes, another opens for you. They see you as very lucky. Like you're always willing to start new projects. Even when other people give up on theirs, you don't. You're like, okay, that one didn't work. Totally cool. And then you move on. It's like this person sees you like not even stopping for a breather. They just see you get a new offer from the universe. And you're like, okay, bye. I gotta go. I gotta do something else. It's very cool. I'm hearing that he sees you get a lot of offers from people that he may not like. I saw the selenite wand and I looked at it. It kind of looks like a heart. I don't know why, but I saw it like a heart right here. The shape of it. I heard Shape of You by Ed Sheeran just now in my head. The Shape of You. And then we have a heart chakra. I heard people that they don't normally like are giving you love offers. Again, if this is your dad doesn't approve of some of these options. But if this is somebody you're interested in, broken heart. Your dad or grandpa is trying to really protect you from storm warning and broken heart, yeah? Because they love you a lot, obviously, and they're trying to make sure that you only get the best of the best. But if this is somebody that you have a romantic interest in, well, I mean, I don't know if you do. They do. They like you. I think more than you like them, maybe. They are trying to protect you from some who they think are bad eggs. Are they? Attachment. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Broken heart. Yeah, well, they probably would hurt you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. How does he see you? He sees you as getting attention from even his enemies, people that he does not like. People that are way beneath you, I just heard. Way beneath you. Way beneath you. This is like your best friend. Your giggle melts me. You are so fucking adorable. It's something about like your sense of humor, your playful nature. With the B, I'm getting like just a like lighthearted, jovial energy, right? And you are the life of the party. I was getting that. If this is your best friend, I'm seeing how many people want you. You can't make it up. I just said that. I'm seeing how many people want you. Wow. If this is your best friend and they haven't admitted feelings yet, oh my God. Oh my God. Like, wow. Especially Pisces, I just heard, or Capricorn, they really want to admit feelings, but I don't know. They're nervous. This person has feelings. They have feelings for you, but it's weird because I feel I'm tuning into somebody who's, you guys have been friends for so long. Some of you might have not even, you might have been friend zoned or something. You might have friend zoned them because you've just been friends for so long. But they're like a big brother type. Like they really are protective of you. Let's get one last card here. The Shape of You. Ed Sheeran, yeah, Shape of You. We have Release here. This person's witnessed you lose a loved one. You could have buried someone. I'm so sorry. I'm seeing a funeral here. I'm also seeing you could have lost a lot of weight or had some sort of life-altering surgery or something on your body was altered in a very drastic way when you were around this person. Shamanism. I'm hearing they see you as a shaman. They see you as a healer. If you're a doctor or a nurse, they think that you have natural healing gifts and abilities that surpass modern medicine. And that you're in the perfect place to heal people. And if you're a dancer, I'm hearing even your dancing heals people. Everything you do heals people. Heard Andrew? Yeah. I'm seeing a dancer. I'm seeing a pole dancer here. I'm also seeing a doctor or a nurse, putting yourself through med school and hearing for somebody. They think you're a gifted healer. Something about womb magic as well. You could be healing your sacral chakra, like your fertility or something. They might have noticed that, or maybe you mentioned that too or something. I think that's it, guys. I'm gonna leave it there. If you want a personal, all the information's in the description. I will talk to you later. Have a good one. Bye-bye.